Hello everyone. Are these lines the same length or different lengths? You might be surprised to hear that they are, in fact, the same length. This popular illusion is called the Muller-Lyer illusion, and in this video, I'll be going through two popular theories as to why this illusion tricks so many people. The most popular explanation for why these lines appear to be different lengths is that our brains look at these lines in the context of a three-dimensional space. The theory goes that we live in primarily rectilinear spaces. That is, our rooms have corners and walls with angles, most commonly in urban environments. Due to this being a regular part of our everyday navigation of the world, our brains apply this concept to these lines. The line with the fins aimed inwards looks like it is closer and smaller, and the line with the fins aimed outwards looks like it is farther away and larger. This concept confused me at first, so I've drawn this illustration as a helpful way to think about this. See? And the lines are still the same size. What makes this theory more interesting is that it has been shown that in cultures and societies that don't live in urban environments or rectilinear spaces, the Muller-Lyer illusion doesn't really work as well. The people in those cultures and societies tend to see the lines as equal lengths. If this is the case, then this could really be a learned illusion that is impacted by our brain's adaptation to our specific surroundings. However, one common point that disproves this theory is when you consider a variation of this illusion with circles. In this illusion, the lines still look like they are different lengths, but they are not angular and aren't typical of rectilinear spaces, which brings us to another explanation. Another theory as to why we see these equal lines as different lengths is that our brain looks at the overall length of the figure, sees one is bigger and one is smaller, and then overgeneralizes that information to the lines. As you can see, this explanation worked for the angular and circular version of this illusion. Our brains process information rapidly so that we can navigate the world in an efficient way. This leads us to believe our brain's initial processing of the information in front of us, even if it is incorrect. And this theory isn't just true of this illusion, it is true of many visual and audio illusions that we see in our day-to-day lives. It's a friendly reminder to not always trust our initial instincts. Is your brain tired? Illusions are fun to look at and can be important tools to understand more about human behavior. The Muller-Lyer illusion is a simple illusion with not so simple explanations that are still being looked into today. Hopefully this video gave you a better understanding and some interest in looking up other illusions and how they work. Which theory about the Muller-Lyer illusion makes more sense to you? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.